and Curry will dribble it out. Mass hysteria here at Oracle Arena. The Warriors do it by becoming only the 10th team out of 233 to win a best of seven series while trailing 3-1. This has been an epic series. The defending champions headed back to the NBA Finals, where once again they'll meet up with LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers. And LeBron this time around has the full cast, Kyrie Irving and Kevin Love. You know, you make memories in Game 7. And this one will be talked about for many years.
Well, you love Game 7 just for the simple fact of the drama that's attached to it. And you don't win 73 games without being able to win on the road. In Game 6, being down by as many as 13 points, and really the Warriors hanging their heads until Klay Thompson, C-Webb, got going and really interjected life to win on the road to force a Game 7 in this building.
Rudy Tomjanovich said it has become one of the best cliches, the best quotes in sports.
The best cliche.
Oh, it's become a cliche. Wow. Oh, it's become a cliche. Never underestimate the heart of a champion, and the Warriors, defending champions, showed that tonight.
Well, you may have heard the Warriors will have a chance to play for their third NBA championship. And a Hall of Famer who was on that first championship team back in 1975 is here to present the Western Conference Championship Trophy to the 2016 Golden State Warriors. Please welcome Rick Barry. Hey, Clay. We'll start with this splash, brother. You're the first team to ever win 73 games. You're just the 10th to ever come back from 3-1 down in a best of seven. And I suppose there should be a question in there somewhere, but you've just come back from 3-1 down in a best of seven.
Yeah, it took a lot of resiliency. We've been doing it all year. Started with Draymond right after game, they made their third win, and he told us, have faith. We made history before. It was not easy, and this isn't going to be easy, but we could do it. And we all believed and just had fun while doing it.
What kind of things are said from player to player when the horn goes off in Game 7? When you see Kevin Durant, you see Russell Westbrook, and these guys who gave you such a battle in this series?
Just try to show them your respects. They're competitive like us, you know. They were hungry. We were just as hungry, and just give them respect because they pushed us to seven. No game was easy. I mean, it was, like I said, give them their respect. They're a really good team over there.
I don't know if they pushed you to seven or you pushed them to seven because you had to come back on them. What happened tonight? What happened tonight in the third quarter? You're down in this game, and then here comes this 26-6 run. How do you guys do that?
Starts with our defense. We play with great length. We trust each other. We got each other's back. And obviously, Steph went in human torch mode, and everyone fed off that. Running the break, getting easy buckets in transition. And we just got to learn that it's tough to beat these teams this late in the season just one-on-one and just move the ball. And that's what we did. It's what the winning formula all year.
Clay, congratulations. And the other splash brother, if you got a couple more answers in you here. Yes. I feel a little rude interrupting that, but I have to. We have to move on. You see it on T-shirts and you hear it all the time, strength in numbers. What exactly does that mean to you when we talk about strength in numbers with this team?
I mean, first it starts with our team. Everybody that stepped foot on the floor, 1 through 14, 15, made an impact on our regular season, on the whole playoff run and this series. So you never know where it's going to come from, and everybody stays ready, which is, you know, that's the only way we can come back from a 3-1 deficit. And then obviously, you know, Dub Nation came strong tonight. We needed it. We needed it.
There was talk after game six. In fact, you said if you thought game six was tough, game seven will be even tougher, even here having the home court for game seven. It's fun for us to watch. What is it like for you to play in a game like this with the stakes so high?
I mean, it means everything. This is what we work for, the opportunity to advance and get back to the finals in front of our home crowd and do it in the fashion that we did it. So we know coming into the day is going to take a full 48 minutes. Closing out a great Thunder team like that is no easy task. And took us to the last minute to get it done, but we're back.
And you're back against the same team that you beat last year for the NBA title. What are your thoughts right now? Look, I know it's early, and I know you just did something that very few teams did. But when you look ahead to a series with the Cavaliers, what do you think?
It's going to be fun. We know what they're about. They've been playing well all playoff series, but, you know, so have we. And we're looking forward to Thursday. That's it. We got a lot of work to do before then, but we're going to enjoy this.
Congratulations, the MVP again, and heading to the finals again. Steph, congratulations. These are your champions, Western Conference 2016, the Golden State Warriors.